Ciao, comrades, and welcome! Vita Homebrew News for the August 2023 are coming your way right about now, so let's get cracking! Let's begin with the latest full-hand PS Vita Homebrew Contest editions. Right now, there are 5 altogether, 1 original game and 4 ports. First new submission is a port of Zigzag by Rene Gattamente, longtime leading Vita Homebrew developer. He already submitted 3 out of 5 titles, great initiative! So, Zigzag is a thinking and reaction game. You follow a small green spaceship through an abstract world and you are trying to reach the exit in each level. It gets progressively harder and there are new mechanics introduced. I like these kind of thinking games because they are not easy. The graphics might be simple, but there is always something more hiding right behind the surface. Second is a port of Beat to X, a rhythm game ported also by Rin. You can choose song pack from 4 options and then you just need to press correct button at the correct time. I've never been a fan of rhythm games and this one is no exception. The only thing I like about it is an urban song pack with pretty kick-ass music. I approve. Install it for free from the link down below. Third new submission in the port category is a Sonic 3 SMS Timelines by M-K. It is a fan-made game, inspired by Master System Games series, that mixes Sonic Chaos and Sonic Triple Trouble in a new universe. Plenty game modes to try, plenty characters to have fun with, plenty new features added. If you are a Sonic fan, this is a must install. There are many quality Sonic ports already available for PS Vita, including Sonic Mania, and this is yet another to add in this retro Sonic Vita collection. Installation is a bit tricky, so I would recommend getting the pre-compiled VPK, for example from our Discord. Also guys, if you are enjoying these videos, like and subscribe because there is certainly more to come. Fourth is a first ever submission in an original games category. It is called 4 of Us Are Dying and it is made by Norad Ninja. It is a technical alpha, that means it is still work in progress. But it was released already, so we can get a feel of what is yet to come. And what is yet to come is quite impressive in my opinion. It is a Silent Hill / Alan Wake inspired third-person survival horror. Creator is trying to push the Vita as hard as possible towards modern AAA quality visuals. And I would say he's pushing it in a very good direction, because the graphics are stunning. Even more so considering it is a homebrew game developed by a single individual. Truly impressive. There isn't much we can do right now in the game apart from roaming around, waving with the flashlight, collecting items and soaking in the atmosphere. I'm eager to see what direction will the game develop in the future. This is a very ambitious project. I like what I've seen so far and I'm looking forward to new updates. For now, that's all the submissions for Full Hand Contest. If you are a creator, you can still submit your project till 22nd of September 2023. If you are a fan and you want to donate some money to increase the prize pool, you know, to increase the amount that will be split among winners, you can still do so. I'm a big fan of Full Hand Contest. I remember QM was a huge success back in the day and I'm sure this is gonna be even better. Good luck to all contestants and be sure I'll be watching closely every new submission. Following new homebrew is Cybershot, a simple game inspired by Atari titles like Spider Fighter. Next, we got a big release of Samurai 2 Vengeance. It is a hack and slash action game, originally developed by Madfinger Games and ported to the Vita by Fang2Z and Sophie Uchiha. It has cel-shaded graphics. Gameplay consists of killing enemies with combos. You got light attack, heavy attack, dash. You break the barrels and collect karma to buy new moves and new combos. This game is unfortunately in Spanish language only. No English available as of right now. Hopefully they will add it in the future, because this is a fun game and even though you can easily figure out what to do, you will not be able to understand the story. Either way, good hack and slash is right up my alley. Go and install it, find out more information at our Discord. Thanks to SquareJackal for sharing it in there. Now let's check some updates. First one is for Halo 2D, where new enemies have been added, rounds have been also added, plus other bug fixes and improvements. Vita Moonlight is now on 0.9.3, pairing issue has been fixed, and it was updated to the latest commit. If you had any pairing issues previously, try it now, it should be fine. PKGJ received a big update to 0.57 and it now supports background download for PlayStation mobile games. Don't forget, for this to work, you need to update your PKGJ as well as the plugin NoPSM DRM. The error popping up while downloading some PS1 and PSP games have been also fixed. Recently, there was a new breakthrough made by these two guys, Skleba and Matiol, that will help us to fix any bricked PS Vita in the near future. They have released a dump of the PS Vita first loader following a successful glitch of the console's boot sequence. To find out more, check the link down below. This is huge, cause up until now, bricked PS Vita was just a paperweight, but hopefully soon it is gonna be recoverable. Last but not least, it looks like Rin has resumed his work on the Ship of Harkanian, aka native Ocarina of Time port. With some optimizations, he squeezed few more FPS and implemented auto frameskip, so no more laggy audio. I'm sure this will make a lot of Vita zealots happy, myself included. Nice one! Thanks to you for watching, thanks to all my supporters, Jarek Smith, Daniel David, Dalai Lama, Grzegorz, Joseph Sandander, Wayne Redding, Patnos D. Your support is greatly appreciated. Like, subscribe, join if you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you in the next one. Do skakavenia, priatelia!